Good afternoon and welcome to another offering of the Women's Super League from BBC Sport live from King's Meadow. Champions Chelsea versus Liverpool in the early kickoff at King's Meadow. And as the teams arrive on a crisp, autumn day, friendly scenes ahead of this 12:30 kickoff. Lots of familiar faces. I'm sure that'll change though, that sort of mood, once the whistle goes for kickoff at 12:30. Let's hear from both managers ahead of kickoff then. We'll hear from the new Liverpool boss, Vicky Jepson, in just a minute. But first of all, the Chelsea boss, Emma Hayes with Reshmin Chowdhury.
Emma, good to have you with us. We know it's taken a little while to hit your stride this season. How important is it to get back to winning ways today?
Yeah, of course. I mean, everybody's looking at us to score goals, especially at home. For me, we just need to continue to create the chances that we are in games. I said it last week, we're entering the penalty area more than any other team, but it's the execution that's been lacking. And the players have been working so hard on the training pitch, so I'm looking forward to the performance today.
Yeah, you say they've been creating so many chances, it's just not ending up in the back of the net. How do you keep the motivation up in that time? You know, is it something where they can get their heads down, or do you just have to keep going?
Do you know what, it happens. It's cyclical how that goes. You know, one year you can hit something, it hits the underside of the bar, the line, and go in. The same with the penalties, and for the moment it isn't quite going for us. I'd be more concerned if we weren't creating the chances, and we are, and the group, as I've said, have been brilliant on the training pitch, and I expect that we'll go up another level today.
Vicky Jepson said that, you know, there is no good time to play Chelsea yet. Someone is due a walloping soon. It could well be them. Do you think you need to be on guard with them as well, considering they've got a new manager they want to impress?
Well, first of all, I mean, it's great for her. She's worked hard to get into that position. Her team are organised. They're tough to break down. If they're on the receiving end of a walloping today, then I'm sorry to give her that on her first day. I'd like that to happen, but I think the reality is that the game will be much closer than that.
Vicky, a big game today, but it is your first game in charge, or full charge of the team. How exciting is this for you personally?
I'm absolutely delighted, but nothing changes in terms of how we go about our game. We've been working together, me and Chris, to compete for the past 5 weeks. So in terms of me getting the title as manager, nothing will change. We know that we're up against a big test today facing Chelsea. They've got a fantastic manager that will develop them and push them as a collective, and they've got some great individuals. So we know it's a big test, but we're looking forward to it.
And how much is momentum key for you with a couple of wins on the bounce as you come here? That's a good position to be in.
Yeah, when you get 3 points, it's that relief, and that's that good feeling where you bounce into training the next week with smiles on the faces and looking to work on and add to what we've already created. But we've been through a tough time, a little bit of turbulence, but the girls have literally brushed off the turbulence, the staff have as well, and we're ready to go again today. We've given our all at 110%.
Okay, a bit of turbulence, I suppose you can say, at Chelsea. It's not been going according to plan. And you say, as you know, rightly so, the champions, they're a difficult team to come up against. But is it a good time to come up against them? Because they're not in form. They can't find the back of the net. Surely this is where you pounce on that.
Yeah, people have said, you know, there's no time to play Chelsea than now with their current form. But for me, they're due to wallop somebody soon, because they've got a team full of class players. So we're just hoping it's not going to be us, and we're going to do everything we can to stop that.
Good luck today.
Cheers.
So here is the FA Women's Super League table ahead of kick-off this afternoon. As you can see, Arsenal and Manchester City level on points, but Arsenal have two games in hand. Manchester City held on Friday night by Reading, a 1-1 draw at the Academy Stadium. We'll have highlights of that at half-time. But this game, Liverpool have staged somewhat of a recovery after Neil Redfern left after the first game of the season. 9 points from their first 5 games. They're above Chelsea, who lie in seventh, 7 points from their opening 6 games, and just 2 goals scored during that period. So helping us guide us through the action this afternoon as we await kickoff here, former Chelsea and England defender Laura Bassett. And it's been a turbulent time, as Reshmin said, Laura, for Chelsea.
Yeah, it certainly has, but they've got such character in their squad. They've got so many leaders, so much talent. You know, you really could pick two separate sides. So I'm expecting a big reaction, a big performance. They're at home. They're so normally so dominant. The last time they played at home, they have Fiorentina, which they won. But before that in the league was Arsenal. So I'm sure they'll want to get those demons off their back.
So we saw Erin Cuthbert there, who is making her 50th appearance for Chelsea this afternoon. Momentous day for her. And Niamh Fahey, one of a couple of former Chelsea players up against her former side, won the double with them a couple of years ago, of course. Laura Coombs also in the Liverpool starting 11, which we'll go through just before kickoff here on BBC Sport. And a huge day for Vicky Jepson. She's been at the club actually since 2009, really part of the furniture there, but given the job on a permanent basis with Chris Kirkland staying as assistant manager and goalkeeping coach. So Laura Bassett, I mean, that is the right decision in your opinion?
Yeah, I think so. And I think from the noise coming from the players and the club, I think everyone's happy. I think in terms of Vicky herself being at the club 9 years, you know, she really does clearly care so much about the club and where the club's going, the direction. And she does know anything and everything there is to know about Liverpool Ladies, from the RTC to the development to the first team. So in order to have that whole club perspective and that one club feel, she's the best person for the job. And with Chris, it certainly seems like they could complement each other very well as he's starting his coaching journey.
As you can see, the players ready to make their entrance onto the field at King's Meadow. Looks like Millie Bright and Carly Telford in a good mood. Here comes Emma Hayes. Just picking up on one thing that Emma said, Laura, in the pre-match interview there. She did say it was slightly marginal, and if you hadn't seen the game against Arsenal, for example, here in their last Super League game at King's Meadow, 5-0 defeat, but actually there were very key moments that turned into a big defeat.
Yeah, that's right. I think Chelsea in that game had the best chance of the game early on with Engman. So if that would have gone in, we could be talking about a very different result and performance. But if you look at Arsenal, who were in form, everything they touch, everything they kind of, and they're working very hard at it, it's coming off. And then you look at Chelsea at the other perspective, at the other end of the spectrum. They're trying their hardest, creating goal-scoring opportunities, but it's just not going in for them. So it's that kind of, you just need to change your momentum and change your look around.
So lots of storylines going on this afternoon. Vicky Jepson's first game in charge permanently. She took one game while Neil Redfern was deciding to leave the club after that 5-0 hammering against Arsenal, although having seen them this season, hammer Chelsea and Reading, that result hasn't actually looked that bad since then. So here come the two teams, Chelsea, the champions. Stuttering start to the campaign. It has almost certainly put pay to the defence of their title. Just one win from their opening six games. Liverpool under new management, but it is a familiar face for the players. Vicky Jepson handed the reins on a permanent basis. Will she get off to a perfect start and pile on the misery for Chelsea? Here are the two teams then, starting with the home side, Chelsea. And Emma Hayes has made two changes to the side that were held at Birmingham last weekend. Carly Telford returns in goal for Hedvig Lindahl. Hannah Blundell replaces Jess Carter at right back. And Erin Cuthbert makes her 50th appearance in a Chelsea shirt. In her first game in permanent charge, Vicky Jepson makes three changes. Christy Murray and Courtney Sweetman-Kirk drop to the bench. Niamh Fahey starts against her former side. Rinsola Babajide makes only her second start of the season. Kirsty Lynette is also included in the starting 11, with Niamh Charles missing from the squad. So speaking after the Birmingham game, Laura Bassett, which I know you were at and you saw, Emma Hayes basically conceded the title. Realistically, she's probably right, but do you think there's a bit of mind games going on there?
I think it was a protection of players, first and foremost. I think in possession, with the amount of chances that Chelsea created in that game, she can be very proud of her players. I think out of possession, I think personally Chelsea can work a lot harder, concentrate more. But I certainly think that was a statement from Emma Hayes, protecting her players, letting them know it's okay, we're all in this together, and trying for them to maybe not take so much responsibility and for not to let them hurt so much, because as players they all care, they all know, they all want to be scoring goals, they want to be winning, of course they do. But I think that's Emma Hayes showing that she'll step up and lead from the front.
And she did mention pre-match there that they had entered the penalty area more than any other side. That wasn't just her stroking her players' egos. That was absolutely correct. The Optostats say that they've had more touches in the penalty area than any other side. So, as you mentioned, it's not for the want of trying, is it? It's just that end product that's missing, which is really surprising considering the personnel they have.
Yeah, that's right. And sometimes as managers, as coaches, you have to look at those facts. You have to look at that black and white evidence to show, because you can't solely go off that. You have to go off your instinct and what you've been training and your game philosophy. But those two complement each other very nice. And sometimes you look at the facts and you look at those Optostats and they sometimes put things into perspective. And sometimes it's just not your day. It's just not going in. But like she said, I'm sure they've been working so hard, knowing majority of those players and the top quality foreign players that we have got at in this league and at that club. They'll certainly be wanting to change things, and I think it does start today. I think that that although they're up against a very impressive Liverpool team that individually have got such bright talent and can hurt any day, and we've already seen beating the likes of West Ham, Yeovil and Brighton, that they'll certainly be up for the test today.
Well, those have all been by a single goal, so we can expect Liverpool to try and keep things tight, but going into this game in positive mood, a new permanent manager in charge in Vicky Jepson, and facing a Chelsea side who, well, from the outside looking in, very low on confidence indeed. The lowest scorers in the Women's Super League, just two goals, the likes of Yeovil, Bristol, Everton, Brighton have all scored more than Chelsea this season. Two goals, they both came in the same game, in a 2-0 win against Brighton. And Chelsea looking to build. Here's Anderson. Beth England spent last season on loan at Liverpool. A successful loan spell for her. 10 goals in the WSL. So she'll know these players more than most, although there's been a big turnover in the summer for Liverpool. Here is Abhijide, England under 20 international. Cuthbert pulled up for a foul.
I think we'll see a lot of that today. Cuthbert and England having to double up. I think Babajide and Jess Clark on the opposite side are really quick, talented players, really good 1v1 dribblers. So I think we'll see certainly Beth England, Cuthbert doubling up and helping their fullback today.
It's Coombs who signed for Liverpool from Chelsea a couple of seasons ago. Now here's Clark. Up against Anderson, gets the cross away. Defending by Millie Bright. In that particular Chelsea attempt at a counter breaks down. Carly Telford making her first WSL appearance since that 5-0 hammering here against Arsenal. Still lots of competitions for Chelsea, of course, haven't entered the FA Cup yet. Neither have Liverpool in the Continental Cup, and have a humongous game in the Champions League later this week. 1-0 they lead on aggregate against Fiorentina. I'm sure with the way their title defence has gone, Laura, that will be a game that they'll be desperate to get through, that tie and into the last 16.
Yeah, that's right. It's always a big focus for Chelsea. I think playing at home against Fiorentina, they really, really dominated the game. It should have been more than 1-0, but I think Emma Hayes emphasised the point that it was so important they got the clean sheet to go away from home on Wednesday with a clean sheet. They'll certainly know what they've got to do, but it won't be an easy tie. Fiorentina did create some good chances against them, and anything can happen in Champions League.
Carly Telford, that was coolly done to Ericsson.
I think that's definitely one thing you can expect from Carly Telford, is a composed, assured possession and pass out from the back. I think she prides herself on it, and she's very, very talented.
Get the feeling she enjoys putting the Chelsea fans' hearts in their mouths.
Yes, well, she's
calm down, get under control.
She certainly enjoys it in training. She likes to think that she is an outfield player and she can mix it with any best five-a-side teams.
Well, goalkeepers always now in the modern game, male or female, about distribution, building from the back. And that's certainly why Phil Neville has been looking at her quite closely, along with Mary Earps, of course, in the recent internationals.
Yeah, that's right. On a serious note, it is so important now with the way the game's evolved, and it's exactly the same for female goalkeepers. The amount of time they probably touch the ball with their feet is a lot more than when they make the big saves or touch the ball with their hands. So it's so important, and I know that now a lot of their training is worked on that, and there's no reason, I thoroughly believe, that goalkeepers should enjoy outfield sessions and be involved so that they get to know the pressure and they get to be so comfortable on the ball.
Here is Jess Clark. Couldn't quite accelerate enough past Beth England. Clark made her 100th WSL appearance against West Ham United last weekend, which Liverpool won 1-0. The Courtney Sweetman-Kirk goal, but she's been benched this afternoon. That's a lovely ball over to Anderson. She's got the better of Murray. Wayward pass. Again, Chelsea struggling to find their rhythm. Not the first time we've said that this season. Lynette, another summer signing. Brief spell at Reading. It's a bit of a loose touch by Roberts. Lundell. It's good defending by Babajide.
It is really good, just to get goal side, force her back and add a little bit of protection to the Liverpool, delay that Chelsea attack so that it gives everybody else a little bit of chance to get in shape.
Appeal for handball by Blundell. I think she was the only one, really, against Leanne Robe. I think that was hopeful. Very close to her, wasn't it? And not even sure if it did hit Leanne Robe's hand.
I think she's having a fine season, Leanne Robe. I think from making the step up, I think it was her stomach there, we can clearly see. But yeah, she's having a fine, from playing in the championship last season, moving up, I think she's certainly established herself in the starting 11. She's a very attacking, athletic fullback, which they have on the other side with Murray. So those fullbacks on the left-hand side and the right-hand side offer such balance, and they're so powerful in driving the team forward.
It's a fairly experienced Liverpool side, isn't it? But yeah, there are the likes of Robe and Babajide, who have very few matches in the top tier of the women's game. A lot of them, of course, joined Neil Redfern from Doncaster Rovers Bells after they won the WSL2 title last season. So a lot of them have had to make the step up into full-time football.
Yeah, and what I'm really impressed about is Liverpool is their squad. You know, with Leandra Little, even more experience. Rogers is another young player coming through. Yana Daniels, Christine Murray is another experience. And Sweetman Kirk, they've got such experience in the WSL. So it's strength and depth. They have got cover.
Millie Bright takes aim. Ambitious, to say the least. Not a prolific goal scorer. Millie Bright's won this season the Champions League. That would have been spectacular.
I'm sure from Millie's perspective, she's thinking, well, you need to shoot. I'm sure she's seen Georgia Stanway shoot from anywhere and everyone and been very successful. So I'm sure in the women's game now, everyone needs to take a leaf out of her book.
It's a good play by Babajide. Lynette forced to hold it up. That's a good turn though, Lynette. Well, that shot caught Chelsea off guard and Telford was relieved to see that fly wide of the post. Stood off her a little bit there, Chelsea.
Yeah, it's a really nice turn from Kirsty. She's so good with the ball at her feet. She can manipulate, go left and right foot. Probably the only criticism is she doesn't get enough for her talent, her ability. She probably doesn't get enough goals. But I know her and it looks like it's either her up top on her own or Courtney Sweetman-Kirk, and they offer very different attributes.
Coombs clearing up. Sophie Bradley-Auckland, the skipper. Here's G. Started in every WSL game so far this season. Sophie Ingle takes aim. Well hit, but straight at the goalkeeper, Fran Kitching.
I think it's good. I think it's positive. I think that we should see more strikes from outside the box in women's football, especially with some of the... We've seen some fantastic saves from goalkeepers, but some also, you know, if they catch the wrong bounce, the goalkeepers are beaten in this league. So it's a really positive sign that they're starting to shoot from outside the box.
Sophie Ingle, another player playing against her former club, rejoined Chelsea rather in the summer from Liverpool. Matthews has presented it to Erin Cuthbert. Here's Kirby. Again, good defending from Sophie Bradley. An easy take in the end, wasn't it, from Fran Kitching?
Yeah, that's right. And she saw it from a long way out. It was hit with a little bit of power, but it was quite comfortable, really central. But again, it just keeps it just a little warning sign that other players might be start looking to do that.
Just from the opening 10 minutes here, Laura, do you see a Chelsea side not really firing on all cylinders just yet?
Yeah, like I say, like I spoke about before, out of possession. I don't think it's whether it's a thing of work rate, but I don't see the hunger, the passion, the desire to win that back the ball as quick as possible, and to really put a tackle in, to really put a challenge in, and to stamp their authority. I think this Chelsea was a team that no side wanted to play against last year.
This is promising though. G, again an easy take by the keeper, Kitching. Promising signs from Chelsea, nice little link-up play. Kirby involved. Chi So-Yun didn't really test the keeper again though. Couple of efforts for Chelsea. Credit to Liverpool, they have managed to restrict Chelsea from efforts outside of the box so far anyway.
Yeah, I think Liverpool have grown into the game nicely. I think they'll be happy with the start. I think they're forcing Chelsea into misplaced passes and like you say, keeping them restricted to shots outside the target, and they've had that chance with Kirsty, a little shining light early on. So I'm sure they'll have a very disciplined game plan at least till half time anyway, Liverpool.
Other games going on today, 2 o'clock kickoffs, Brighton against Yeovil, Everton against West Ham, then at 3 o'clock, the outright favourites now surely for the WSL title, Arsenal away at Bristol City. That's a 3 o'clock kickoff. You can see all the highlights tonight on the Women's Football Show, 11:30 on BBC One, right after Match of the Day 2. Here is Anderson. Well, that's lovely play by Chelsea. Again, though, well cleared up by Liverpool. Clark back in her own defensive third. England. Now Kirby. The layoff for Spence. Oh, what a brilliant goal line clearance. That was heading into the far corner. Sophie Bradley-Auckland. What a brilliant bit of defending.
What a great bit of attacking play from Chelsea. And again, it came from the high pressure, losing the ball back from Beth England. Nice layoff.
Kirby. Bit too deep. Millie Bright couldn't keep it in. Good pressure from Chelsea. Goal goalkeeper was beaten, wasn't she?
Yeah, I didn't see Sophie Bradley-Auckland on the line until the leg came out last minute. But this is a lovely layoff. Drew knows exactly where she's trying to put it. But I've seen, having played with Sophie Bradley for so many years, I've seen her do that time and time again. She's an all-action hero, and she has a never-say-die attitude. And she certainly reads the game well to be able to pull off goal line clearances like that.
England's ball to Kirby, too much weight on that. It's almost like a second goalkeeper, wasn't it, back there defending, yeah. Right on the line.
But yeah, that Chelsea chance came from a good reaction, losing the ball, Beth England, then winning it back straight away, enabled it Frank Kirby to pick out Erin Cuthbert. And those are the things in those transition moments, they need to stay alive, because they certainly have got the talent to punish teams in that final third.
Here's Coombs. Clark. Trying to show her pace against Anderson. Not too many options, Clark. Manages to get the cross in. Bradley Auckland. I think that was an effort, wasn't it? Not bad.
Well, if
very far out.
Yeah, very far out, but she's just made a goal line clearance, so maybe she thinks it's her game girly early on. Can't blame her.
Three wins so far for Liverpool, just the one for Chelsea, and four draws, all goalless draws as well. And the one massive defeat here against Arsenal for Chelsea. Been a very disappointing defence to their title. I think they will probably look elsewhere for silverware, as well as trying to progress in the Champions League. Made a good start to their Continental Cup campaign. Of course, we'll try and defend their FA Cup title as well. Still in the very early stages of that competition. It's a great turn by Cuthbert and a good reverse pass as well. Kirby trying to pick out Hannah Blundell. And a player with Kirby's quality, she may have been able to take a shot from there.
Yeah, she certainly looks to bring in her other forwards all the time. And you're right, sometimes you want Frank Kirby to go alone, because she's certainly got the capabilities and attributes.
Sophie Bradley Auckland's effort. Catching practice for Telford. Blundell nearly assisted Kirsty Lynette. That was a vital clearance by Millie Bright. Spencer's given it away. His robe. Abidjide. Has gone Chelsea's way. Liverpool have a really dreadful record against Chelsea. Lost each of their last nine meetings. The last time they beat them was in August 2014. That was on their way to the WSL title. 2-0 win. The scorers were Gemma Davison and Lucy Bronze. Just shows how long ago that was.
Thanks, Robin. I'm sure the Liverpool fans that are watching this won't have liked it like that statistic.
It just shows, though, that, like Arsenal, won the first two WSLs, haven't even got into second place since then. And then Liverpool had a couple of years of dominance, and then have dropped off a little bit. And it looks like it might be happening to Chelsea a little bit as well. Here's Kirby. Tried to play in Hannah Blundell. Well read again by Babajide. She's been excellent defensively. And now she looking to stretch her legs here. Good run by the England under 20 international. Good strength as well. Maybe one touch too many. It's a crunching challenge.
That was great. great defending from Babajide, and then the powering through, breaking the line, starting the attack, trying to get Liverpool up the field. Fantastic.
Coombs with the cross over the head of Lynette. She was the only player with a red shirt on in the box. Not committing too many players forward, understandably, from a Liverpool perspective.
I don't think no one could keep up with Babajide, the way she powered through the centre, and then, like you say, I think Chelsea defended it well, stopped the counter-attack. But yeah, I think that'll take a couple of minutes to recover from that defending and that run.
Back in position now, Babajide, and here's Ingle, Wales captain. Spence. It's a lovely ball to Cuthbert. Oh, and again, a goal line clearance.
That was a lovely ball from Drew Spence. A little chip. She's seen Erin Cuthbert always on the shoulder. Chip ball. And then Erin, no one just in the box, waiting for a tap in.
Chelsea just starting to find a few pockets of space now. G, Spence, Erin Cuthbert. Oh, that's a loose pass. Blundell. G. Beth England scuffs the shot. Here's Kirby.
What a wonderful chance that was. Great play. Fantastic from Hannah Blundell to keep that ball in.
It was actually ended up being quite a good assist by Kirby, by England rather.
Yeah, G's so composed in those situations. Beth tries to hit it first time, and then Fran on the spin. I think she's just probably spun too quickly and a little bit disorientated on her left foot. That's it. The chances are coming now for Chelsea. I think they're keeping possessing the ball really well in Liverpool's final third now.
Two goal line clearances from Sophie Bradley Auckland.
Yeah, she's always in the right place at the right time. And that's why she's such a leader for any group of players that she plays in, and especially this Liverpool team. She loves defending, takes such pride in her work.
Chelsea's season in microcosm. Chances and lots of touches in and around the penalty area, but they just haven't managed to break the deadlock. And when they have managed to get the shot in, Sophie Bradley Auckland's been there. Spence fouled by Fahey. For Chelsea from the set piece. Looks like Erin Cuthbert's going to deliver.
Yeah, Chelsea have the capabilities to be so dominant from set pieces with the delivery and the players that can deliver such quality balls in the box, and then with their height and strength in there. I'm surprised they haven't scored more, to be honest.
It's Anderson. Decent delivery. Well defended by Liverpool once again.
Of course, Frank Kitchen used to be at Chelsea too, so I'm sure that's another player that knows each other well. She'll certainly be looking for a good performance today.
You didn't really get a chance at Chelsea, young keeper.
No, that's right, but I think it's just the training facilities, the environment, the culture, training with Stuart Searle, who's highly recommended and respected in the women's game, in the goalkeepers' union.
Cuthbert. Defended again by Liverpool. It's really been a hallmark of their campaign since that 5-0 defeat against Arsenal on the opening day, especially when you start off a season in that sort of, with that sort of result, Laura, it must be really difficult actually to recover and regroup, but they've done it really well.
Yeah, that's right. But I think especially the first game of the season is always a bit strange because you've put all this hard work in pre-season, you've got up to date with your physical data, and pre-season friendlies have maybe gone your way, haven't gone your way, and you just kind of, you've played with no real pressure, that pressure feeling. You haven't really played with it until that first game of the season. So you never really know what to expect anyway. And if it's even better than what you thought, it's a bonus. And if not, like you say, if you're on the losing end of 5-0, then you're certainly, it's a quick reality check, and you need to stay positive because games are coming thick and fast.
That was good positive goalkeeping from Fran Kitching. It's the Liverpool assistant manager, Chris Kirkland. Still learning his trade under Vicky Jepson. Ingle. Ball by Bright, the layoff by Spence, didn't find Kirby. Gorgeous. Clark. Trying to show her trickery. Caught by Blundell. Oh, the referee's given a goal kick.
Yeah, I thought she caught her. She played the ball out of her feet, although it was a heavy touch. But there you go. That's got to be a foul, I'm sure. I'm surprised the referee hasn't given that.
Chelsea have got away with one there because that was a very good position. Down the other end, here they come. Erin Cuthbert wins a corner. So Tara Murray, one of the old heads really in terms of being at Liverpool since 2015. A little sabbatical to go home to the USA to complete her studies. Our mainstay at right back in this Liverpool squad. It's a good delivery. Spence is there. Oh, what a goal! Magdalena Eriksson opens the scoring in style. Went for the spectacular and pulled it off to perfection.
I know, I think that first touch, I wondered if anyone was going to close her down, if she took a too much of a big touch, if you like, but she waited, she didn't get closed down, she knew exactly what she was going to try. Great to keep it alive from Drew Spence. And then there you go, the overhead kick.
Well, it looked like the whole of the defence was worried about Millie Bright. There was about three of them round her. No one was looking at Magdalena Eriksson. Her first goal of the season might be one of her best.
And there we go, a set piece, that corner delivered into the box. Like I was saying earlier, they've got such good delivery from a numerous amount of players. And then with Eriksson, with Bright, with Drew, how physically strong they are and powerful. I'm surprised they, you know, don't keep the ball like that in the 18-yard box more often.
Foul and a free kick to Chelsea. That bit of magic might just be the spark that ignites their season. It's been seriously lacking in quality so far. That was unbelievable technique from Magdalena Eriksson, and to have the presence of mind, the composure to even attempt that, most of us would have just come up with a back injury.
That's the defenders, the centre-back, what a goal. When centre-backs score goals, they're normally top class. And that was certainly one we've been waiting for.
Laura Bassett, former centre-half, of course.
Never scored an overhead kick, not even in training.
Still time for that.
I'm sure from a Liverpool perspective, they could have defended the corner better And they'll just need to keep tight. They don't. You just at this point, you do not want to allow Chelsea to get on top and score that second goal.
It was quite a scrum, wasn't there, when it was the corner was swung in. Just bodies flying everywhere, and Eriksen was the calmest head in the penalty area.
That's right. Drew Spence did really well to keep the ball alive in there, but although that was a free challenge, it wasn't competed. So from a Liverpool perspective, they've certainly been disappointed with that. She's clearly got a marker. But no, Eriksen showed a class of composure and a international prowess that she has got.
And this is all about game management, isn't it, as you said, Laura, because Liverpool obviously at some point now need to commit a few more bodies forward, but not just yet.
Yeah, that's right. It depends what your manager believes in. He could, you know, when a team scored, they could be the most vulnerable because they think they're comfortable now, they're settled in, so you could get at them. Or you might take the more cautious approach and just get compact, get good shape and don't let them score again. You want to go in at half-time in the game, 1-0 up, draw, or 1-0 down, because that next goal then in the second half is crucial. It just depends on what your manager believes in.
Half an hour gone and Chelsea lead. Deservedly, they've been the dominant side. It's taken something pretty special to break the deadlock. Here is Coombs. What a ball that is. Fantastic. Jess Clark with quite a lot of space here. Millie Bright's there now. Great defending by Bright. Worrying though for Chelsea how much time and space Jess Clark had. One ball from midfield.
That was it. I think Jess Clark saw that Hannah Blundell had committed going forward, and she saw the space in front of her. She made the run. Coombs picked up the pass. It was a really nice weight of pass into the channel. And in the end, had to be some splendid 1v1 defending from Millie Bright.
Clark. Clearance is deflected. It's Fahey. It's a good touch by Jess Clark. Good feet as well. England gets her foot in. That's a lovely play. Great turn of pace by Frank Kirby. Cuthbert opening up here for Chelsea, but G's pass is poor. An uncharacteristic loose pass by Ji-So Young.
Yeah, it was a really nice passage of play. Nice counter-attack from Chelsea. Frank Kirby done extremely well. And like you say, G just didn't concentrate on that last little ball, and it was overhit, and Drew Spence couldn't get to it.
Make sure you stick with us at half-time. We'll have highlights of Friday night's game at the Academy Stadium, 1-1 between Manchester City and Reading. Terrific game it was as well. And we've seen a very good goal this afternoon. You'll want to see also Georgia Stanway's screamer, although I don't think she scores any other types of goals really, Georgia Stanway.
She's certainly in fine form at the moment.
It's a good ball by G. Not quite executed to her standards. It's a good idea though. Chelsea with all the possession in this first half. Is Ingle. Cuthbert. Just put off enough by Roberts.
She's such a tenacious player, Cuthbert. Both in and out of possession, she's tenacious, she's aggressive. And she's a really hard player to play up against. And I know she's very highly respected within the Chelsea team. And although a young player in terms of age, she certainly doesn't play that way. She plays with a lot of responsibility on her shoulders.
Especially for her national team, of course. Scotland into the World Cup finals in the summer. Just need to keep them all fit. It's It's really disappointing when they reached the Euros and basically the whole spine of the team was out with injury. The likes of Jem Beattie, Kim Little, of course.
That's right, it's disappointing and so sad for those players and also their teammates, the staff members and all the fans and all the opposition. You want to opposition, other countries want to play against the top players, the top teams in the world. And like you say, with a team like Scotland to having qualified and finally reached those big tournaments, you want them to have the best opportunity with the best players. And certainly those players that you mentioned are certainly some of the top players in the world. So why wouldn't you want them there in those big comps?
Hopefully they can all just stay fit and we can see how they do.
And of course, all the English players staying fit. wrap everyone in cotton wool.
Well, it's not been a bad start to Vicky Jepson's permanent managerial career. She will have been disappointed with the way they defended that goal, but can't really argue with the finish. So beautifully placed, wasn't it, by Eriksson, just out of the reach of the goalkeeper.
Yeah, that's right.
Eriksson, the goal scorer. Anderson. Post play by Liverpool. Murray. He's just lost it. Good play by England. Right with the diagonal towards England. It's a good header by Murray. Kirby didn't quite get the angle right on that pass. That goal has really settled Chelsea down, hasn't it? They just look like they're stroking it about with a lot more confidence than
That's
they have
right.
been.
I think it's relief. I think, you know, to finally get that goal, to get ahead in the first half, especially not having to wait till the second half or not having to dread that voodoo 0-0 draw again. But to score a spectacular goal like that, I think you can see from the players' faces, their celebration, that wow, what a goal, what it took a special goal to kind of lift us. And like you say, now they're playing with such confidence, composure, everyone wants to be on the ball. And Liverpool at this time kind of need to sort their press out because Chelsea can come through the middle or they can go down the sides. So they're really dictating Chelsea at the moment.
Bradley Auckland's forced to put it out of play for a corner. Liverpool haven't really offered anything up front, have they? Speculative effort from Bradley Auckland. Can Chelsea repeat the trick from this corner? Played short. G. Towards Bright. Ingle. Towards Spence. And get the power on it.
It's interesting today that Liverpool are missing Neve Charles, whether that's through injury, but she's such a great attacking player for Liverpool. She's such a talented player that she'll really be missed today. one of those players that again plays older than maybe her age and her experience, but she's certainly one to watch in this WSL season, and she has been for a couple of seasons now, but she's a big loss for Liverpool.
Family day out in the WSL. They've been treated to a spectacular goal. I want a few more bits of goalmouth action. Eriksson, Cuthbert, finding a bit of space. We haven't seen so much of Babajide since she switched wings with Jess Clark.
That's right, but I think her and Jess Clark are having to do so much defending, helping their fullback double up, and also Anderson and Blundell are getting forward on such regular occasions that they're having to track them. So they're not all of the time, they're getting deeper and deeper, and it's harder to get out of your own half. But you're right, I think if Liverpool can identify that when Blundell or Anderson have gone forward and to exploit with the pace of Babajide and Clark, they might be able to get higher up on the counter and really do some damage.
Lovely slide ball pass by Bright. Spence gets the shot in. Didn't quite catch it. Did just open up for Drew Spence, didn't it?
Yeah, she gets a head up. She identifies that there's a shooting opportunity, and the earlier you can shoot, the more difficult it is for goalkeepers. And big credit to Drew Spence. You know, with what's been happening in recent matches with lack of goals, it's certainly not deteriorating her positive attitude to take the opportunities in this game, and that's exactly what you need.
Great turn by Cuthbert, and that's really good defending by Murray. Matched her stride for stride.
That's one thing you need to know about Murray. If you do manage to get away with a jink or a turn, you need to either cut across her release or sprint really fast, because Murray's getting back at you. She'll have a second nibble at you.
Sounds like you're talking from experience.
I don't get that high up the pitch to do be a 1v1 with Murray, but she does it time and time again. She's so powerful and so quick, she can be beaten. She gets back.
Here's Cuthbert, the layoff to Kirby. Oh, England following up. Bit of a fumble from Kitching. Frustration again for Frank Kirby.
Again, lovely set by Cuthbert. Fran's trying to pick a spot just to get the execution right. And I think Beth England's got every right to go in for that. It was bouncing, and luckily there wasn't much contact. She pulled out, and Fran Kitching was able to get both hands on it.
Side flag is up against Kirsty Lynette. Just trickled out of play. Liverpool throw. This would be a much needed win for Chelsea, but haven't secured it just yet. Liverpool are going to have to twist at some point. They'll probably at this stage, they'll just be trying to see it out, go in at the break just to goal down.
I think you can see with the team selection that Liverpool have gone with defensive maybe first half, playing both Niamh Fahey and Rhianna Roberts as two controlling centre midfielders. Normally we see one or the other, not both, in previous selections. And then maybe second half we might change that and bring on a Christy Murray who's more of an attacking midfielder, or maybe a Sweetman Kirk and have Sweetman Kirk and Lynette on rather than one or the other.
Minutes of this game. It's a good delivery, well defended. It's Babajide trying to set it up for herself, deflected. Safety first from Blundell. Babajide. Telford gathers.
That's a nice, great touch from Babajide, and she knows exactly what she wants to do straight away. She's striking that ball. It's comfortable in the end for Carly Telford.
The official has indicated a minimum of 1 minute and on time.
She certainly showed her attacking threats this first half in glimpses for sure.
Just 1 minute of added on time. Late. Bit of pressure by Liverpool. Kirby dispossessed. Touch by Coombs. It's promising, but Blundell there ahead of Lynette. And that is the final action of the first half, which has been dominated by Chelsea, who lead by a goal to nil, thanks to an absolutely spectacular effort by Magdalena Eriksson. Liverpool, though, not out of this yet.
No, they're not. And I think we've seen Leighton get a set piece, a good delivery into the box. Babajide still bright, and Jess Clark still really lively. They've still got Courtney Sweetman-Kirk, who's a very industrious. She put a lot of pressure on that Chelsea back four if they made that substitute. So still things, I'm sure they'll be going into the half positive and still in this game.
So let's have a quick look at the major incidents in that first half. Chelsea really dominant from the start, and Kitching having to make a couple of regulation saves early on.
Yeah, I think the Chelsea team talk would definitely be, they know Fran Kitchen, they know her strengths and weaknesses, and it would have been to test her, get shots off as quick as you can, however far out you are, lay it off. And that certainly was a great goal line clearance from Sophie Bradley-Auckland.
Incredible positioning from Bradley-Auckland. Another opportunity there for Frank Kirby. Eventually, the breakthrough was made, and what a goal. That's all we can say, really, can't we?
Yeah, and there you go. Maybe she had so much time because half the players were on the floor and got obstructed in that melee. I think Jazz Matthews tried to get pressure on the ball, but Eriksson had already made her mind up, and she knew exactly what she was doing.
And Bradley-Auckland, who's been involved at both ends, first of all, clearing off the line and then really having Liverpool's best opportunity, a speculative effort at best, though.
Yeah, that's right. Sophie Bradley-Auckland is certainly a very strong, a very stubborn defender. She won't want any team to score on her and her team unless it's got to be a great spectacular goal, and that's exactly what we've seen.
So this is the second game of the WSL weekend. Manchester City were in action on Friday night against Reading, hoping to go top of the table, and it was quite an eventful night at the Academy Stadium.
The champions Chelsea are stuttering. Can Manchester City make the most of it is the question. The 2016 title winners want to be the best in the country again. Inside to Weir.
Apologies for that. A few technical issues. We'll come to the highlights of that in a second. But Laura, you were there on Friday night, and it was a fantastic game, really high on quality, and a great response by Reading, who were absolutely thumped by Arsenal in their previous game.
Yeah, that's right. It was critical for both teams, and I think Manchester City had the better of the first half. They controlled the game, really knew what they were doing. It was, once they got the first goal, it was a matter of time. But I think Reading came out. They were a whole new different side second half. They made the substitution of Jabe Moore, and I think they just competed on all levels, all fronts, and really matched Man City.
Let's try this again, second time round. The highlights from the Academy Stadium on Friday night between Manchester City and Reading.
The champions Chelsea are stuttering. Can Manchester City make the most of it is the question. The 2016 title winners want to be the best in the country again. Inside to Weir. Jill Scott had held her position and looked to try and place one. BT, Bonner, Horton, all forward from the back here. Hard in at pace, it came off the head of Jane. Nodded in by Jill Scott, cleared by Remy Allen. Stanway hits one from a long way out! Oh, what a goal! Tremendous hit from a wonderful young talent. And in front of the watching England manager, Phil Neville, Georgia Stanway scores one of the goals of the WSL season.
And that's why Stanway tries them, because she's capable of putting it in the top corner. And you can see how it felt. She only had one thing on her mind, as it did fall in front of her.
Moore with the cross, which is deflected. A little bit of indecision, and Farrell Williams almost profited. Off the line it was.
Farrell Williams had guided that to the far corner of the net until Gemma Bonner put a foot out. It was a terrific play from her.
Almost 5 minutes gone in this second half. Farrell Williams with the ball over, and that's it. And they've got the equalising goal here. And it's, of all people, Jade Moore.
That's just a commanding leap. She gets to it first. Jade Moore, it's the last thing I think she expected was to get in there and score a goal. But you see, I think Steph Horton just duck a little bit there. I don't know whether she got a shout from behind her. Watch Steph Horton just ducks her head right at the last minute, as if she got a shout from Jill Scott or someone behind her. She was in a particular position to clear that there, so a little bit of misunderstanding.
There's the ball for Paris, and now Stanway gets in the box. Very close to a second for Stanway. Stanway with Paris in support. Weir making a run into the box. Paris, and still Nikita Paris. Good save by Grace Maloney. Paris. Now it's Woolart. Still time yet for a winner. Woolart drives one in. Oh, so close!
Now she comes inside, and then it's a terrific strike. So close to getting that winner for Manchester City.
Jade Moore with the second half equaliser for Reading. City missed the chance to go top of the WSL, and it finishes at the Academy Stadium. Manchester City 1, Reading 1.
We knew this was going to be a tough place to come. They've been scoring goals for fun over the last couple of weeks, so we knew we had to do what we needed to do, and we needed to be aggressive, we needed to be on the front foot, and that's what we've been about since we've been in this WSL, so it was a case of going back to that and delivering that.
We got into a lot of good opportunities to go and get the second goal at 1-0 and even at 1-1, but I thought our decision-making in the final third just wasn't at the level it's been in the last two games, and hence why we didn't score more goals.
It's a very fair point from Nick Cushing, because Manchester City, as you saw there, especially after they conceded the equaliser, had more than enough opportunities to go ahead and get the win. But we've got to see this goal again from Georgia Stanway, Laura. Incredible again from the youngster.
That's right, and she's under pressure from Bruton. Lauren Bruton's coming the wrong side of her from the high side, and she just knows what she just wants a touch to settle it down. And then she knows exactly what she's doing. That technique, the outside of a boot, she just knows. And I'm sure everyone in the league knows that all the team, all the goalkeepers, she's going to shoot. But at the minute, she's unstoppable.
Lots of WSL action today, and you can see all of it on the Women's Football Show tonight. BBC One, 11:30, 12 o'clock. Bit of a later start in Scotland. So later on this afternoon, Bristol City host Arsenal, and two Dutch stars have been at the centre of everything good this season for the Gunners. This week, the Women's Football Show caught up with them, teammates at club and international level, Vivian Miedemar, and a very familiar guest reporter, Daniela van der Donk.
So we won 5 out of 5 games. We got one girl that's on fire. Her name is Viviana Miedemar. She's in there. Let's go talk to her.
Brilliant from Miedemar. Fantastic centre-forward play.
Miedemar's there.
Oh, that's delightful. There's the hat-trick.
So, Viv, 3 more goals last weekend. Already 9 in the season. Which were your favourite ones?
Game against Chelsea, of course, was like a really hard game, so it's good to score in those games. But as well on the weekend, like I think the 4-0 it was, I think it was an amazing team goal with Beth laying off to Katie playing that cross in. And yeah, for me then it's an easy finish. I think that's just like the goals we like to score.
Tell us things about you that we don't know.
A lot of people don't know is that my name is actually not Viviana Miedema. It is Anna Margaretha Marina Astrid Miedema. Quite a mouthful, I know it's really hard, but yeah, my parents gave me this name.
Your 3 most influential teammates.
Good, say that again.
No.
Leah Walty has a really important role in our team. Basically, like, is the one in front of the defense. Gives you the ball, gives me the ball, which is really important.
Shows off with her snake hips.
Exactly, her snake hips are unreal. I would say Kim Littles. Yeah, I think she's just a really complete player. And then I think you've got a lot of players like yourself are just really important on the pitch to do like their hard work to help me getting my chances as well.
Thank you, Viv. I hope
Thank you.
3 more goals
really
in the weekend.
Maybe we can do this again.
Other leading by a 0-2. Let's head pitch side with Rashmin Chowdhury, who's with Shelley Kerr.
Yes, I am indeed. Thank you very much, Robin. Shelley, we've been watching this game, sat over there. Chelsea well on top, of course, not just with the result, but certainly with their performance. What do Liverpool need to do to come back into this?
I think the movement of Chelsea's front three, England, Cuthbert and Kirby, is causing Liverpool huge problems. So I think they want to try and play higher up the pitch. They're playing very deep, and it's understandable because Chelsea have got good quality. But for me, they need to play maybe 15 yards higher up the pitch and try to put them under a wee bit pressure.
OK, do you think they can do that?
I think it's going to be difficult, especially based on the first half.
Yeah, Chelsea really dominating this game, aren't they? Well, let's talk Scottish football, because it is going to be quite a day north of the border. Glasgow City chasing a 12th consecutive Scottish title. They take on Spartans later. Hibs, though, are hot on their heels. We sent our resident Scott Ailey Barber up north to meet them as they chase their famous Glasgow dozen.
Football is woven into the tapestry of this city. It's home to Scotland's two biggest football clubs, but when it comes to winning titles, nothing surpasses Glasgow City's 11 in a row, and they're now on the brink of number 12. But their domestic dominance has been severely tested this season. As we go in to the final day of the campaign, they are yet to get their hands on silverware.
As a coach, get a job when a team's not doing well or a club's not doing well. But I took this job and the club were doing well. They were winning, and I had to come in and make sure that they continued to win, and that's a different pressure for a coach.
We've obviously had huge disappointments in the Cup, and for a club like Glasgow City, we're kind of expected to go and win trophies.
All these kind of tougher games, you know, in the Champions League, to lose to Barcelona 5-0 away, to turn up against Hibs again in the league and to take the 3 points was massive for us.
There's such a high standard here. How important and how difficult has it been to maintain that throughout the couple of seasons you've been back at the club?
I think this season has been the most challenging. Let's not forget the whole of Scotland is hoping that one day Glasgow City don't win a title, and we get that. We get that at the club, but just because other people hope that doesn't mean that we are quite ready to accept that.
We're on the verge, hopefully, winning the 12th title. Reached the last 16 of the Champions League. We're truly punching above our weight in that respect.
We've still got that grit and determination as a squad, and I think that's probably what's got us through.
Every year we need to rebuild a team. The calibre of players that we lose every year, I don't know how long the club can sustain it, to be honest. Look at the players that are playing professionally now. You're Emma Mitchell, Lisa Evans, Jean Ross, Denise O'Sullivan, Rachel Corsi, the list goes on and on.
So women's football is developing so fast now that the opportunities are just, they're endless.
We need to look at investment, we need to look at improving clubs further and trying to keep our better players now within Scotland.
Is this a really exciting time for the game here, do you think?
It is exciting that, you know, we've got the national team, a World Cup to look forward to. You know, there is a lot to shout about at the moment in women's football and in Scotland in particular. To win 12 league titles would be an unbelievable achievement.
Yeah, it certainly would be an unbelievable achievement to win those 12 on the bounce. I suppose you wouldn't bet against them, would you? Would you?
No, absolutely not. I think they'll get over the line, no problem. But it's great for Scottish football that it's been competitive this season and it's went down to the last game. That's what we're looking for.
Yeah, and that's exactly the point, isn't it? Because Hibs have been up on their heels, haven't they? It is about time, and you want to see that, don't you, in the domestic league?
Well, Glasgow City won't, but everyone else would. I think you need a competitive environment. And for me, it's been great for Scottish football that it's been kept going to the last 2 weeks of the season. Hibs have been dominant in terms of cup competition, and that's something that's eluded Glasgow City, so they'll be absolutely raring to go today to get that title.
OK, well, that match kicks off at 10 past four. Just a quick word as the players start to come out onto the pitch. Are we looking at a Chelsea win today? We badly needed 3 points.
Based on the first half, I think so. I think their movement's been incredible up top. You've had wide players coming inside, and they've been dominant in that first half.
Yeah, OK, well, let's see what happens. The teams are out. Time to hand you back to our commentators, Laura Bassett, who's alongside Robin Cowan.
Thanks, Rashmin. We'll be back with her after the game for some post-match reaction. And as it stands, Chelsea heading for just their second win of the WSL season. But Laura Bassett, Liverpool showing signs of life towards the end of that half. They really haven't tested Chelsea though yet, have they?
No, that's right. I think credit to Chelsea. They've been very stern. Millie Bright, Eriksen have been very strong along with Carly Telford. That tripod have been very strong and resilient. And I just think that because Liverpool have had to do so much defending, it's such a long way, and it's so you having to be so reliant on the likes of Jess Clark, Babajide, Kirsty Lynette to hold the ball up and bring other players in. But because they're so deep, it's hard to get up. But as we saw just before half time, it looked dangerous from a wide free kick. So if they can keep their positive signs, keep driving the team forward, maybe make some changes to add a little bit of impetus, you never know. But it'll be interesting to see how strong this Chelsea team start this second half.
It's nice to see Emma Hayes with a big smile on her face. She hasn't had much to smile about this season. She really enjoyed that goal. You can see Magdalene Eriksen has actually been one of the more consistent players. Actually, ever since she signed for Chelsea, she's been magnificent and actually overlooked quite a few occasions.
That's right. I think her and Anderson, that left side, left-footed balance, are so great for this Chelsea team. I know that they've got a wealth of full-backs with Ali Riley, Jess Carter, Hannah Blundell, Anderson, and there's other players, numerous players that could play in that position too. They're spoiled in that area. So, but yeah, you're right. Eriksen and Anderson certainly had the probably up there with the best left-footed technical players in this league.
Frank Kirby to get us underway in the second half. Had a couple of chances in the first 45. Just the one goal in the WSL for Hurt this season, although five in all competitions. It's just because of her reputation, the one that she's built up over the years. It's always a shock when she shoots and it doesn't hit the back of the net. That's a good pass from the back by Matthews to Coombs, and now Abajide. Well read by Eriksen. Sort of flashes of the pace that Babajide possesses in that first half. It's an intelligent ball. Annette can't take that under her spell.
Like we just saw there, the gaps and the spaces are there behind the Chelsea midfield. If Laura Coombs can stay composed like how she is and find those balls to Babajide. Babajide played it through to Kirsty. The spaces are there.
Anderson's ball. Easy take for Fran Kitching. Kitching and her, one of three players in this the Liverpool starting 11 who used to play for Chelsea. Here's Lynette. Really starved of any service in that first half, Kirsty Lynette, the lone figure up front.
That's right, and receiving the ball like that back to play with Millie Bright applying such intense pressure. But as a centre forward, as a lone striker, really need to hold the ball up and be able to lay it off so your other teammates can get up the pitch. But it's a difficult task with such pressure from Millie Bright.
Here is Millie Bright wearing the captain's armband. With Karen Carney on the bench. Maren Mielder also missing with injury.
It'll be pleasing when Maren Mielder is fully fit and is introduced back into this side, because as long as she is fit, she will come straight into the starting 11. She has that much of an influence on this Chelsea team, both in and out of possession.
That's an excellent ball by Coombs. Jess Clark is in here. Clark straight at Telford. Chelsea exposed. One good ball and Clark was in.
What a great chance this is. And I think Jess's run stayed on side. She knows exactly what she wants to do. She's had a look at the keeper before she controls it. And it's a big warning sign for Chelsea that, but really, really positive for Liverpool that they're still in this.
Here's Beth England. Good movement from Anderson. Wins the... Thought it was going to be a corner, but the referee's pulled it back for something. Positive signs for Vicky Jepson and her charges early on in this first half. It's great to see the interview before the game. She looked absolutely delighted, didn't she? So excited about taking charge for the first time.
Yeah, I think when she's been at a club for so long, had many different roles, to finally get that top job, to be given a chance, and she certainly put the work in over the years and to be certainly earned her stripes. It must be such a great, proud moment for her and her family and friends. But as she said in her interview, nothing changes. You know, it is about the players, it is about the girls. I'm sure the players are very used to her. She's been in the first team environment for a while. They know her sessions, they know how she likes to play football. So in that respect, there's no big, huge changes, which I think at this stage of the season is comforting.
And which is why I think the general consensus anyway was that it was the absolutely the right decision in terms of continuity to give her the job. Neil Redfern left, of course, after the first game of the season. And the partnership of her and Chris Kirkland have really steadied the ship.
Yeah, I think Chris Kirkland can come in and he could offer the new innovative. He's a new voice that the girls are still getting used to listening to and maybe responding to. He can offer such a... He knows what it's like to be a player, be a professional, play at the top level with the pressures. And I'm sure he can be a big learning curve and a shoulder to lean on for all the players, as well as having such an important role to the goalkeepers.
Yeah, it must be a real thrill, actually, for the goalkeepers to have someone of his standing, former England goalkeeper. Have lost it in a dangerous area. Here's G. Cuthbert. It's deflected. It's good play by Leanne Robe. Very cool, calm, collected. Fahi puts her foot through it.
You're right, it was really good defending. I think to stay on your feet and guide G off the ball like how Leanne Robe did is a much tougher task than she made it look.
Signed in the summer from Millwall, Leanne Robe, and has made that left back position her own. That's a good play by Babajide. And now Jess Clark. Oh, that was so close. Just trying to thread it through towards Coombs, who was unmarked. Great ball by Roberts. Lynette retrieves. Just took a little bit too long on the ball, Kirsty Lynette. They're finding these passes, aren't they, Liverpool? Very accurate.
Yeah, that's right. And like you say, Laura Coombs was in top of the screen. If Jess Clark could have found a little bit of extra pass to get it to her, but she was in. It's big warning signs.
She's starting to cause all sorts of problems, Jess Clark. That was a very cynical challenge by Drew Spence.
Drew Spence, luckily not to get a yellow card there, to be honest. I think we've seen her do that in a few games. Did she get one?
Yes. There we go.
I mean, it's clever from Drew Spence and from a Chelsea perspective, but from a Liverpool, you would be disappointed. It's, like you say, it's very cynical, and you can't get away with that in this day and age. I just beat Stacey, the referee, to it.
It's definite booking, wasn't it? Coombs loops it up. Roberts was there. It's good delivery. It was a good win by Rhiannon Roberts.
It was. Rhiannon Roberts is good in the air. Sophie Bradley-Auckland, Niamh Fahey, so strong. Satara Murray. They've got some really good athletes to aim for.
You do suspect maybe set pieces will open up a few doors for Liverpool in this second half.
Yeah, I think we're seeing it more and more. They're becoming more and more important in the women's game. I think they always have done, but we see Reading as set-piece specialists now, scoring on Friday night on a set-piece.
Cuthbert. Matthew's got a body in the way. Corner kick to Chelsea. Brave defending by Matthews. That was travelling.
It was. She hit that nice and clean with such. She got over the ball, kept her head down, and that was flying. Looked like Jess Matthews trying to duck out the way, but she managed to get a shoulder on it, which I'm sure her team were relieved about.
And there's Cuthbert, who delivers. Eriksson just glances it wide. Chelsea ready to make a substitution. Maria Torres-Dottier ready to warm up. Looks like that gentleman just behind the goal is trying to warm up as well.
Certainly on his toes, trying to get the blood flowing.
It's that time of year now. The tipping point we all decided was yesterday. It's now officially winter. Big coat time, all the thermals, all the layers going on when you're going to see a football match now.
Double socks. Don't forget to put two pairs of socks
at
on.
At least. I think I reached double figures last year during the snowy days, appearing at football grounds looking like the Michelin man. She's got the right idea. There you go, the bobble hat, an essential item.
That's the winner, that is.
Liverpool gain some territory. Just wonder if Vicky Jepson will maybe think about making that change up front. Kirsty Lynette hasn't quite managed to get the ball down and get herself into the game. Worked incredibly hard, as we mentioned. That lone striker role is pretty thankless, isn't it, at times? Here's Kirby. G. Liverpool do so well, don't they, to get back, get into their shape.
Yeah, they're such honest, hard-working players. Like you say, recover, goal side, back behind the ball, get close, connect, make the connections in defence. And then Sitara Murray uses a strength like that.
That's terrific defending from Murray. Eriksen swings it in, it's an awkward one. Goalkeeper went for the punch and it's wide and it's a Chelsea player down as well as the goalkeeper. Beth England now getting to her feet. I think Frank Kitching did really well there actually, because that was a really teasing delivery from Eriksen.
You're right, it was. It was high, looping. She's done well to punch it, but I'm not too sure in the end if it was a clash of heads. And I think if you're a goalkeeper in that situation, it's better to make sure you're okay in that situation.
Right decision. Not even going to attempt to try and catch that one.
No, she was under severe pressure by Beth England.
It's resulted in the corner for Chelsea. Eriksen went down there. I'm asking the question. Recycled his Ingle. Anderson. Good defending once again.
I think it's a big sign for Liverpool. As soon as it's set back to Anderson, Eriksen, it's coming straight. It's been delivered straight back in.
Well, a bit of a scrum there, really. Don't think there was any intent to make the foul. Just tripping over each other.
Yeah, I think it's a good block. Good shoulder to shoulder.
It's a good delivery again, just wide. Eriksen again, getting on the end of these corner kicks.
That ball from Erin Cuthbert, that's twice now we've seen. It's faded, it's low, it's really, really easy and agile to attack. And I think he's crying out for a goal. And these chances, they're certainly looking very dangerous from corners. I think Liverpool need to tighten up and maybe prevent giving away such easy territory. And it's a free ball into the box, and Erin Cuthbert certainly put in some really creative balls into the box.
Oh, gee, that was an excellent pass. And Cuthbert maybe manages to prevent the goal kick. Throw in, good pace from Cuthbert. Coombs just ran into traffic, spent with a bit of space. It's
Good play by Blundell. Robe sticking to her. Clark working ever so hard, trying to get the ball back. Here's G. Cuthbert, charge down. Looks in some discomfort, Erin Cuthbert. Just have a look at this. Oh, the ball just whipped up onto her face. Not pleasant on a cold day.
No, not at all. I was going to say, when she made the shot, I didn't think there was anything wrong with her then. It was certainly a powerful shot. It was a good block by Bradley Auckland. But yeah, she just caught the nasty bit of that on the ball, that just the end of the end of her nose. That would have hurt.
Maria Torres Dottier ready to enter the action. Be interesting to see who for and which position she takes up. She's played as a wing back, a full back, and actually in midfield as well. I think that was against Arsenal, which obviously didn't work so well.
No, we haven't seen her in action since we saw her in action against Arsenal. She hasn't featured in the last two games, whether that's been injury or out of the squad. But yeah, you're right. She could come on for anybody in any position.
Looks like it's Drew Spence who's making way. Yes, Spence's afternoon is over. Maria Torres Dottier coming on. That might mean a little bit of a reshuffle, we'll just have to see.
Maybe we did see Torres Dottier playing midfield against Arsenal, but Drew coming off could be something to do with the yellow card. You wouldn't risk that at this stage. There's no real need to. You're 1-0 up, only 30 minutes left. And you've got an action-packed week ahead with Champions League too.
Yep, Champions League on Wednesday in Florence. 1-0 they lead on aggregate in the round of 16. And then next Sunday away at West Ham United in the Women's Super League, and then another international break. Phil Neville names his squad later this week. Interesting to see if he recalls Georgia Stanway. G-Day. It's a little bit overzealous in trying to get the ball back. Here's Anderson. It's a lovely ball. Oh, England couldn't keep it down. Unmarked, that was a huge chance for Chelsea.
It's a great chance. I think Anderson, this is a lovely ball in. She's got time, space. She knows exactly where she wants to put it. And I think we would have saw Beth England score that, for ironically, for Chelsea when she was on loan there last season. But it's a great run, and everything was right apart from that execution. I think Fran Kitchen would have been beaten if it had been for a better connection. That's definitely the best chance of the second half.
Yeah, she came, Fran Kitchen, didn't she? Didn't get there. England got in front of her. Just couldn't get over it enough. Babajide, great strength again, though. Pulled up for it. She's not happy. And she may have talked herself into the book, or just a telling off, we'll have to see. Yes, I think it was probably for the afters, not for the actual challenge, Babajide.
It's certainly been a great contest between her and Hannah Blundell. big learning curve for her, playing against some top international defenders now.
20 years old, Babajide, still learning. But no lack of effort or passion, of course. G, now Blundell. Lovely little touch and turn. Another corner kick. They've looked threatening from these positions, Chelsea. They've got another target to aim for in Torres Dottier now. Oh, it's clever. Blundell with the late run. And it's wide. I think she was trying to pick out Millie Bright.
There's great improvisation though. Everyone was expecting Cuthbert to put in another fine ball, but it's a late run from Hannah Blundell. The space is there. She just, like you say, whether she's trying to curl it in or find Millie Bright, but she just didn't really connect with it on that weaker side.
The marking, though, from Liverpool from those set pieces hasn't been great, has it? Caught out again.
That's right, but who do you prioritise? There's so many dominant players in the air, and you just have to try and, if you're not as big, you have to try and just get as close as you can and block. And prioritise those maybe that are stronger and bigger and more profound in the air.
Babajide does really well to win back the ball. Torres Dottier. England. Gets the cross in, not far away. Cuthbert threw herself at it. Just can't get this second goal.
Really positive play by England. I thought she was going to carry on and get herself into the 18-yard box, but she gets the defender on the back foot and delivers a fine cross. Just a little bit too quick, I think, for Cuthbert. Maybe the time in the run, she went a little bit too late and didn't identify that the cross was coming in, but another good chance.
Decision's gone Chelsea's way. Blundell now seeing a lot of the ball down that far side. Torres Dottier. England's pass cut out, but one back. Lovely play by England. Anderson can't pick out a teammate. Oh, and that was very late.
It was a really late challenge by Cuthbert there. Really overzealous.
Sophie Bradley-Auckland isn't going to complain, but that was a bit naughty from Erin Cuthbert. And receives the booking.
I don't think she can have too many questions regarding that. Sophie Bradley, good position. Picked up the ball, good touch. Cleared the ball. Yeah, whether she's trying to block the ball or not, I don't think she's intentionally trying to hurt her, but you know, if you catch a foot as she's followed through to strike the ball, then it is a yellow card.
All the yellow cards that the referee has dished out, three now. Spence off the pitch has been justified. Liverpool change coming now. Yana Daniels ready to come on.
And she's replaced by number 11, Yana Daniels.
Kirsty Lynette has made way. Yana Daniels on for her. It's an interesting change.
Yeah, it'd be good to see Yana Daniels back in action. She hasn't really got a lot of playing time over the last few weeks. But maybe you see Babajide with a pace centrally. Maybe that ball over the top that we saw that Jess Cart got in and had a shot on target, that's maybe the balls that they might start to be playing, and Yana Daniels maybe having to do the defensive work covering Anderson. So it'd be interesting to see how it figures out and see if they change their style of attack.
Well, they're going to have to go for it at some point. There's still 20 minutes remaining. They've managed to keep the score down. Still very much in this. Murray invites Babajide to chase.
You just hope that Babajide gets some kind of quality, maybe the balls in the channels in the space, or maybe over the top, so she's not doing tirelessly endless running and she burns out. You still need quality balls up to her.
Here's Murray. Here is Yana Daniels. It's a good ball. Well defended by Blundell. Jess Clark was right behind her, ready to pick up the pieces. Coombs goes for it. Charged down by Sophie Ingle, and maybe Chelsea can turn defence into attack. Blundell. Kirby. Again though, Liverpool right back at it. Good shape. Torres Dottier. Good challenge by Coombs. Babajide catches Eriksen. Looking incredulous, but I'm afraid that is a foul.
Yeah. I think if the defender was to tackle like that against an attacker would certainly want a foul. So again, just you can see how hard she's working for the team and trying to set the tone from the front.
It's another thing I love about you footballers is that look of absolute bafflement, even though it's a clear foul. Some of you, she really perfected that. That was brilliant.
We have to be innocent. Referee.
Who, me?
I didn't touch her. That's the funniest. And then you see it on the replay and you wipe someone out. Oops, maybe I did a little bit.
Gide, battling for it, just lost her feet. She's got to be careful, Abajide. It's the goalkeeper's come. She had to get that right. Nearly took out a couple of members of the crowd as well. Here's G. It's a good play. England's there, Murray. Again, brilliant defending. She's had an excellent game, Sasara Murray.
Yeah, I think the whole Liverpool back four have been robust, really compact and had some fine defending, great positionally as well. They know their roles, they know their responsibility.
Torres Dottier. Anderson. Just floats over Frank Kirby. Just wonder if someone might have to have a word with Rinsolo Babajide because she's looking a little bit frustrated and already on a booking.
Yeah, maybe. I think maybe for some of the older, more experienced players too. But also it's that edge. Sometimes it gives the players the edge that they need to be playing on to make something happen. You have to believe that. You have to keep yourself in the game. So it's a fine line, yes. But sometimes it's that competitive. It gets you out of your comfort zone. And it's that edge you might need to really be such a threat throughout the rest of this game.
Oh, Liverpool lose it with Murray. G trying to tee up Kirby. I think that's been another impressive aspect of Liverpool's game. They've tried to play it out, and when they have made that mistake, they've just managed to wriggle out of it.
That's right, they don't dwell on mistakes, they react well. That's what you'd have to do. You have to keep yourself in the game, not dwell on mistakes, and do your next job.
Torres dotted. Can't find G. Here is Babajide. Not too many options. And draws the foul.
Already we've got her. She's such a central threat. Somebody, you know, with her pace that she offers, somebody needs to foul her. And with Torres Dottier, miscontrol, then give a sloppy ball away. It's maybe easier sometimes if your midfielder recovers to do that so your centre-backs can stay in shape.
Coombs will try and cause some problems in the Chelsea penalty area. Plenty to aim for. It's defended by Chelsea. Jess Clark can't quite get it under control. Now here's Kirby. You can see the red shirts flooding back. Anderson. Oh, that's a good delivery, and England's missed another chance.
What a ball that is by Anderson. I think that's now the third, fourth ball we've seen into the box. They're so dangerous, and it's just asking to be put away by anybody in that 18-yard box. It falls to Beth England like the header did. And you can tell she's sliding. She just needs to keep over the ball, but she knows that. But it's good, it's positive. I think if Anderson keeps delivering those balls, the finish is going to come.
And here is the change for Liverpool. Christy Murray on, Nifahi off. That's a positive substitution for Liverpool.
Yeah, it is. And Murray's such a hard-working player as well, but she's got really good technical feet. And she can spot those intelligent passes forward to feed Jess Clark, to feed Babajide.
Telford's managed to clear the stand. It's impressive.
Murray's certainly got the ability to shoot from long distance, to draw a penalty maybe, so it's a positive change, hoping that she can be a game changer and create something.
Babajide, good feet, lovely turn, still going. Cross is just behind Yana Daniels. Bradley Auckland. That's a good ball towards Murray, who's gone down. Didn't make too much of a fuss about that.
You're right, but it's a long ball. It asks questions of the Chelsea defenders and Carly Telford coming out. It's asked a lot of questions. They're a bit of uncomfortable. And they get away with it that time, but again, another little positive note for Chelsea.
Well, she was in behind.
Yeah, she did get a touch on it, it looked like, Murray, to try and control it, to bring it down. It would have been a fantastic touch if she would have brought it down. That's a really hard skill to do.
Chelsea just haven't managed to put this game to bed, which means that Liverpool will still feel confident they can get something out of this. Of course, a goal now, and that would surely be it. Anderson, G's missed it. Again, fantastic play by Yona Anderson.
I think she's having a fine game. I think it's a bit of both. I think she's getting a lot of time and space to deliver balls, but she's certainly executing them, and she's been up and down and such an attacking threat for Chelsea all game.
Babajide in a foot race with Hannah Blundell. Wants the throw.
the decision doesn't go her way by the look on her face.
All credit to her and her Liverpool teammates. They certainly haven't ran out of steam. They've competed toe-to-toe with Chelsea. And I'm sure her GPS stats at the end of the game will be up there, because she certainly had covered a lot of ground and she's been such an attacking threat, and that our Chelsea defenders know they've been in the game.
Beth England, you can see by the look on her face that she's disappointed. She's had the best chances in this second half. She hasn't managed to put them away. And so Ramona Backman comes on in her place. Cheer up, it's not that bad, is it?
He maybe was expecting a few more goals. This one.
Hard man to please, yeah, it's been a decent game. Been really impressed with Babajide. She hasn't featured too much, mainly from the bench, since signing for Liverpool in January. Oh, the keeper didn't come. Sophie Bradley-Auckland was screaming at Kitching to come, and she has had to put it out for a corner kick.
That's right, it was a ball over the top. She doesn't come, and so Sophie Bradley-Auckland has to take control in that situation.
Well, the referee stopped play. Two players down, head injury. This looks serious. This does not look good. The Liverpool players were calling over the medical staff immediately. And Emma Hayes is on the field.
It's really important the medical staff get on, and like Emma Hayes was saying, players get away and let the medical staff do what they need to do.
Very concerning scenes here. You can see by the reaction of the players that it's serious. Stretcher already on. This looks like it's going to be a lengthy stoppage. You just see this happen, don't you? Two committed players going for the ball. Maybe a clash of heads. Let's have a look at the replay. Just a clash of heads, it looks like. Just have to wait and see what the outcome is here, but of course you don't want to take any drastic action in these situations, do you? Take as much time as you need.
Yeah, that's right. The welfare of these players is the utmost important, and the medical staff, they're professionals for a reason.
Well, while we're waiting for this stoppage and the medical treatment to be administered, let's have a look at the only goal of the game so far. And it really was special from Magdalena Eriksson. Kept it alive herself, actually set it up for herself, didn't she?
That's right, she set it up with her right foot and finished it with her left foot. That's what you practice as a kid in the grass fields over and over again, but you don't expect to do it in a top competitive game. But all credit to her.
Well, and she might have just snuck in goal of the month on the 28th of October. Jasmine Matthews is up.
It's great to see. She's up and walking away.
Torres Dottier, the Chelsea player. thank goodness for that. It looked very, very serious. I'm not sure if they were maybe knocked out, not sure, but I doubt that they'll be able to continue.
Like you said earlier, Robin, two fully committed players watching the ball. Sometimes that happens, mistimed attempts to win the ball in the air.
Leandra Little will come on for Liverpool for Jasmine Matthews, who was in that collision for Liverpool. There will be a lengthy stoppage time then at the end of this second half. Leandra Little, the club captain, on for just her second appearance of the season. Like-for-like substitution. And there's Torres Dottir. I think Matthews came off worse, but Torres Dottir is clearly not very comfortable at all. I think Chelsea will just wait to see if Torres Dottir is willing to continue. Just see her over on that far side. We are hearing that they will make a substitution. Kitching makes the punch, and actually G was pointing to the edge of the penalty area, claiming that Kitching had handballed it outside.
She certainly came out very fast and blurred the lines between the top of the 18-yard box and where she actually made contact with the ball.
Here's Cuthbert. G. Let's have a look at this then. Fran Kitching. Well, it was decisive, but she may have just got her angles a little bit wrong. Let's have a look. That is very tight, isn't it? Difficult to tell, really.
The assistant referee was in perfect position to make that call. They were probably in the best position. But, yeah, certainly very brave.
But risky move.
Yeah, very decisive. She convinced everyone there.
Again, G can't quite find Fran Kirby. Daniels comes away with it. With an aimless pass. 2 o'clock kickoffs are underway. Brighton Yeovil and Everton have taken the lead against West Ham. Claudia Walker with the goal there. Bit of a difficult start in the top tier for West Ham United and Matt Beard.
That's right, quite a mixed bag. I think West Ham have struggled with injuries as well. So that hasn't helped, but they're certainly learning a lot of lessons from this WSL in these opening 5-6 games.
Adelina Engman. There she is, the Finnish international, has come on in place of Maria Torres Dottir. The final few minutes of this second half. Backman. Kirby. Trying to keep it in. Decision's gone at Liverpool's way. The heavens have opened. At King's Meadow. Babajide was just waiting for it to come there. Great play by Murray to pick it up. And tenacious play by Cuthbert to win it back. G. It's good vision. Blundell. Now Engman. Defending by Rogue once again. Here's Kirby. G. Into the arms of Kitching. Daniels. It's a good turn of pace. Erin Cuthbert, well wide. She connects with it well though.
The fourth official has indicated a minimum of 6 minutes added on time.
Well, the weather has deteriorated quite rapidly and quite incredibly. And Kitching, you can see from her facial expression.
Doesn't seem to be any warning sign either, it's just gone down.
6 minutes of time added on because of that collision between Jasmine Matthews and Maria Torres Dottir. Slipped by Cuthbert.
I think we'll see Liverpool really positive and keep putting pressure on Chelsea in these last 6 minutes. They've got nothing to lose. It could be quite a shaky 6 minutes for Chelsea. They'll just want to see the game out now.
By Anderson. Chelsea played in absolutely atrocious weather against Arsenal, didn't they? And now, just the final few minutes here. Had all four seasons, haven't we?
Yeah,
lovely, lovely sunny day and then raining, hailing. Goodness me.
Clocks have gone back, the winter is here. Get the fire and the heating on and the candles.
If you needed confirmation, here it is. Clark shows too much of it to Blundell. Misjudged header by Little. It's a good play by Roberts.
I think Vicky Jepson can be so proud of her team, the effort, commitment, execution, a game plan. I think that for this first game that she's been officially in charge, I think she can be extremely proud of her players.
Still time for Liverpool to get something out of this. Chelsea have been wasteful, especially in this second half. I just wonder if Liverpool just presented with one more opportunity to try and force the draw. Backman offside.
Backman's been fairly quiet since she's been on. Normally we're used to her picking up the ball, driving at players, committing, linking up so well with Frank Kirby, but we haven't really seen her feature much.
Great strength by Babajide. And now Clark. Tries to go around the outside, gets the cross in. Too close to Carly Salford.
I'm sure Carly Salford at this point will try and manage the game, slow it down. There's no rush. Get as much distance as she can on her kick.
Given it away. I think Rhiannon Roberts was lucky that she didn't connect with that challenge. Oh, that's a poor pass by Kitching. G tried the
creative approach to playing in Ramona Backman. Just over a minute left of stoppage time. Obviously Liverpool needs to get possession of the ball, but at this stage, do you kind of maybe lose 2-0 while trying to force an equaliser?
It's difficult. It's difficult just to try and turn that switch. But I think they've had moments. I think they could have capitalised a little bit more on, for, like I was saying, Jess, Babajide. They certainly haven't run out of steam. But like you say, it's easier against a top side, top team like Chelsea, who possess the ball so well. It's easier said than done just to get the ball back and create some more chances. But in terms of defensively, Liverpool can be certainly very proud of themselves, how they've conducted themselves in this game.
That's the salient point, isn't it? You need the ball to try and force an attempt. And
sometimes that's it. The longer you go, the more direct you go, the more you turn over the possession and you lose it anyway and you can't get numbers. So you have to have a little bit more strategy about your attack.
I think this might be it. Throw into Chelsea, closing in on just their second WSL win of the season. And there is the final whistle. It is a victory for Chelsea, deserved. It could have been by a lot more. Magdalena Eriksson, with a bit of magic, has won this game for Chelsea.
Yeah, and rightly so. You can see smiles on her face, and Carly Telford, I'm sure, is thanking her. But yeah, thoroughly deserved by Chelsea. Quite a few chances created, a miss that we've seen, but like I say, big credit to Liverpool, the way they've conducted themselves. I think Babajide has made a claim for a starting 11. If there's any way that Vicky Jepson can maybe get Neve Charles, Jess Clark, Babajide, Courtney Sweetman-Kirk and Lynette into the team, they've certainly got some very attacking threats. So a lot of positives. They can certainly be proud of themselves, but deserved by Chelsea. And I'm sure they'll kick on now in Champions League on Wednesday.
Just their third goal of the season, though, Chelsea in the WSL, but they have won this one by a goal to nil. Magdalena Eriksson with the decisive goal midway through that first half. And let's have a look at it. Worth watching again and again, Laura Bassett.
Yeah, that's right. I'm sure she will be tonight. Like you say, it's just the right foot control, but and the left foot finish, and she actually lies down and then jumps up when she hears the crowd's response. She lies down like, I've had an attempt at goal, and then realise it's gone in, and then jumps up to celebrate. Really, really proud moment for her.
Chelsea, well, they dominated and they missed a few chances. Some robust defending on that occasion by Sophie Bradley-Auckland, and then just not quite finding that final finish to really wrap up this game.
No, that's right, but in certain amount of the chances, the crosses into the box, the goal-scoring opportunities, we're all, again, really positive side. I think Vicky Jepson's right, and she says that Chelsea will, as she says, wallop a team in some stage, and they will connect in a game at some point, but they just need to keep working hard, creating those chances, and it'll come, I'm sure.
And as for Liverpool, the Vicky Jepson era is up and running, and not the result she would have wanted, but overall performance, apart from maybe a little bit more in the attacking third, she'll be fairly pleased with, won't she?
Yeah, I think so. I think for all the things that you can control, your attitude, your tenacity, endeavour, all those things that players can control, they certainly put in a shift. They worked for her tonight, today, and she can be really proud of them. And then now it's back to the training field, and her and Chris can really, really start implementing now that they know their role. Everyone knows exactly in what direction and who with, then they can really start down to pin down their game plans for the foreseeable future.
And we were grateful to see that a Liverpool player in Jasmine Matthews and Chelsea player in Maria Torres-Dottir were up after a pretty sickening clash of heads.
Yeah, that's right. It's brilliant to see them both being able to get back on their feet, walk themselves off the pitch. And we hope with either there's no repercussions, it's nothing too serious. And we hope that they're able to train and perform again very soon. But yeah, all credit to the medical staff who dealt with this situation really quickly.
Let's get some reaction then with Reshmin Chowdhury. She's with the Chelsea winner, Magdalena Eriksson.
Magdalena, Liverpool did push you, particularly in that second half, but you held on for the victory. How precious are these 3 points?
So precious. That's all what second half was about, was to just get the 3 points, get more confidence with that. And yeah, we're so pleased with the 3 points today.
It's been so hard, hasn't it? Creating the chances, waiting for those goals to come. And when they did, well, wow, that was quite a stunner. Talk us through that overhead kick.
Yeah, I think I'm blacked out. I don't really know what happened, actually. I just tried to go for goal, and it wasn't the smoothest thing I've ever done, but it went in. So very happy with that. And I think we played really good in the first half. We created enough to score, and then it was just all about getting those 3 points.
You did try one of those kicks, didn't you, in pre-season?
I did, actually. So, yeah.
Practice makes perfect.
Yeah, exactly. It's been coming.
And how much confidence does this give the team, knowing that you put your Champions League game against Florence during the week and then West Ham away next weekend? It's so important, isn't it, to get that momentum?
Yeah, of course. Like, today it was a step up in the performance. We created enough to win the game, definitely. And I feel like we've been doing that the last games as well, but to actually get those 3 points today, it was so good. And then in Florence, we have the advantage. It's all about having a clean sheet and perhaps scoring as well. So,
wishing you luck. Well done today, and I'll let you go and get warm.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Magdalena.
Well, you can watch all the action from all the weekend's football in the women's game. The women's football show is tonight at 11:30 on BBC One. Slightly later start in Scotland at midnight. Well, thank you very much for watching once again the BBC Sports coverage of the Women's Super League. It's been a terrific match once again. Enjoy the rest of your Sunday, and we'll see you again very soon.